On Days of Our Lives, Ben is still in Salem, while Sierra is still being kept hostage in a bubble, somewhere. But why should that be an impediment to romance? They spent an entire episode dreaming about being Romeo and Juliet, reciting poetry in sync. Was that enough to quench the thirst of fans dying to see them reunited? What over 2,000 wanted us, and the powers that be, to know? That was so romantic, 54% of you swooned. Ben and Sierra really are just like Romeo and Juliet. If she'd only been presumed dead. And if he hadn't killed himself the moment he found out. And the Shakespearean dialogue they recited was just like their regular dialogue. Only with fewer references to fixing motorcycles and getting pizza. It was so nice to see them together, even while apart. And without needing Susan and her visions to act as a conduit. That leads to less screeching. If they can't be together in body, at least they can be together in spirit. And it sure beats Ben chatting with Sierra's ghost only for that ghost to turn into a figment of their imagination once the dearly departed returns in the flesh. A slightly smaller 46% of the audience said yeah, the dead white man canon is fine, but how about some hot living white man action with the hot white chick he's married to? In other words, you don't want poetry, you want the real thing. You don't want sonnets, you want sex. Enough with the dreaming and the psychic visions. Bring on the reunion and the celebrating. They have a lot of lost time to make up for, and these and thous aren't going to cut it. Days of Our Lives airs weekdays on NBC. Check your local listings for airtimes.